Here's how to stabilize your videos using Premiere Pro in less than 3 minutes. So in my timeline, I have a few clips from story blocks, which look nice and stable, but there's one clip I filmed handheld, which is a bit too shaky to match. That's the one we're gonna be applying stabilization to. Once your footage is in the timeline, head over to the effects panel. If you don't see it, you can navigate to Window, Effects. In the search bar, type in Warp Stabilizer. This is the primary tool for image stabilization in Premiere Pro. Drag the Warp Stabilizer effect onto the shaky clip in your timeline. Premiere will then begin analyzing the clip automatically. While it's working, you can adjust settings like Smoothness and Method under the Effects Controls tab. If you don't see it, go to Window, Effects Controls. These settings allow you to fine-tune how the stabilization affects your video. Adjusting these will help you achieve the perfect balance of stabilization without making your footage look unnatural or wobbly. Smooth motion is best when you want motion in your frame, while no motion is best when you intend for the shot to be static. Smoothness determines how much of the effect is applied to your footage. Typically, the higher the number, the more warp stabilizer will crop into your video. Method refers to how Premiere attempts to stabilize your footage. Position, scale, and rotation, perspective, and subspace warp are typically the options you'll want to cycle through here. At this point, you'll notice that stabilizing cropped into your footage. This is normal, as Premiere Pro stabilizes by adjusting the edges and cropping into the frame. By checking Preserve Scale, you ensure that the scale will be consistent throughout the stabilization, and it won't zoom in more or less. Framing determines what processing you'd like Premiere to do after it stabilizes. By default, it's set to Stabilize, Crop, Auto Scale, which will be best for most applications. Now, coming down into the advanced settings, there's a few parameters you can adjust if you're still not happy with the result. Detailed analysis will require more processing and be harder to render. However, it usually yields better results. If your footage pans quickly, it may have significant rolling shutter artifacts. In that case, you'll likely want to explore enhanced reduction under the rolling shutter ripple settings. And that's it. You now know how to stabilize video in Premiere Pro to ensure smooth, professional-looking results. If you have any questions, leave them in the comments below. And subscribe for more tips and tutorials just like this.